Minister, at 6 o'clock this evening outside the Saudi Arabian Embassy, a protest will take place organised by the National Union of Journalists and Amnesty International to highlight the plight and the persecution of Raif Badawi, who is a liberal from Saudi Arabia who set up a website called Free Saudi Liberals, which called for a debate on freedom of speech in Saudi Arabia and for separation of church and state. For his trouble last year, he was sentenced to 1,000 lashes, floggings, over a period of 20 weeks, which coincidentally began, the punishment began, in the same week as the killings in Paris of the cartoonists in the Charlie Hebdo offices. He received the next 50 lashes the following Friday, and tomorrow he will get another 50 lashes, and that will continue for another 17 weeks. He will then serve 10 years in prison, just for calling for freedom of speech and separation of church and state. His journalist has also been sentenced to 15 years in prison for criticising human rights abuses in Saudi Arabia. And of course, this is against a background where 83 people last year were beheaded in Saudi Arabia, and whereas, as one journalist, Italian journalist, put it recently, when it comes to beheadings, ISIS has nothing over Saudi Arabia. Now, I want to ask a very simple question. Given the justified outrage that was expressed by our Taoiseach and world leaders, going to the trouble of going to attend a mass rally in Paris after the Charlie Hebdo killings, declaring their commitment to freedom of speech, declaring their outrage that anybody would suppress freedom of speech and attack or persecute or kill journalists, where is the outrage? Where is the condemnation? Where are the demands for action and leniency by the Saudi Arabian government? Where are the declarations that this will not be tolerated, that we will take action against Saudi Arabia over this persecution of a journalist, and indeed that we will do similar things elsewhere in the world, in, for example, places like Israel, where 17 journalists were killed in the Israeli assault of Gaza, justified by the Israeli Defence Forces officials publicly, no condemnation, no rallies, no marches, no threats of sanctions, and yet world leaders flocked to Paris saying they will not put up with the persecution of journalists. It was right to do it in Paris. Why do we say nothing when it comes to Saudi Arabia in this particular case? Will the Taoiseach be joining the demonstration at 6 o'clock, which is only around the corner, if he went to the trouble of going to Paris a couple of weeks ago? And one has to ask, Minister, if there is not consistency in upholding freedom of speech, defending journalists' right to freedom of speech everywhere, then can we really take the declarations of a commitment to freedom of speech that we saw in Paris last week seriously? Indeed, I have to say, Minister, it was utterly nauseating to see Benjamin Netanyahu on that protest when he was responsible for the killing of 17 journalists. Not a word said about it in Gaza. No protests, no rallies, no world leaders joining marches. So I ask, can you explain these double standards? And very specifically, will the Irish government speak out loudly and angrily about what is happening to Raif Badawi? Will we demand that there are trade sanctions put on Saudi Arabia? Will representatives of the government join protests demanding his release and the end to persecution of journalists and people who wish to engage in free criticism and speech about social and political affairs in Saudi Arabia?
Thank you, Deputy Minister.
The case of Raif Badawi, which the Deputy refers, is clearly a matter of ongoing and serious concern. Our concerns relate both to the conviction of Mr. Badawi for activities which would be widely regarded here as the peaceful exercise of his right to freedom of opinion and expression, and also the nature of the sentence, which included corporate punishment. The carrying out of this sentence began with the public flogging Mr. Badawi in Jeddah on the 9th of January 2015. had the opportunity this afternoon of meeting with the Director General of Amnesty International, Ireland branch, wherein we had an opportunity of discussing the case. The concerns that I have and the concern that the Irish government has about this case have been repeatedly raised by the European Union on behalf of its member states, including Ireland, with the authorities in Saudi Arabia. When he was convicted, and again now that the punishment has commenced, they've also been conveyed directly to the ambassador of Saudi Arabia here in Dublin by senior officials in my department. EU embassies in Riyadh, including Ireland's, are continuing to work intensively on this case. In addition, the spokesperson of the EU High Representative Mogherini issued a statement on the case of Mr. Badawi on the 9th of January. This called on the Saudi authorities to suspend the flogging of Mr. Badawi, a call which was echoed again on the 15th of January by the UN High Commissioner for Human Rights, Zayed Raad Al-Hussein. I sincerely hope that the Saudi authorities will answer the High Commissioner's call for Mr. Badawi to be pardoned and for this harsh and unacceptable form of punishment to be urgently reviewed. In the meantime, I welcome the fact that the second session of punishment of Mr. Badawi, which was scheduled to take place on the 16th of January, has been postponed. I also welcome the reports of a further postponement, which have emerged just this afternoon. The reports that this case has been referred to the Supreme Court is a positive development. And I hope that this will presage a wider rethink of this case and the important issues it raises by the Saudi authorities. We normally raise human rights issues, including specific cases such as Mr. Badawi's, in conjunction with our EU partners in Saudi Arabia, as we do in many other locations. It's quite clear that we have the greatest impact on matters of foreign policy, including human rights, when the 28 EU member states speak with one voice, as we are doing on this issue. Ireland has always been at the forefront internationally in raising human rights issues, through bilateral contacts, through the European Union and the United Nations, and we have never shied away from addressing these issues. As you may know, the government's review of the foreign policy to Global Island, which was launched last week, underlines the government's continuing commitment to promoting human rights. Ireland specifically sought and fought for election to the UN Human Rights Council as one means to fulfil this commitment. Membership provides us with the opportunity to make a positive contribution to the work of the Human Rights Council and to the global protection and promotion of human rights. As a member of the Human Rights Council, Ireland makes specific recommendations to many countries on human rights issues under the Universal Peer Review Procedure. In October 2013, Ireland made two recommendations during the UN Universal Periodic Review of Saudi Arabia. Let me assure the Deputy, let me assure the House, that Ireland will continue to follow closely the human rights situation in Saudi Arabia and to monitor the case of Raif Badawi in this context.
Deputy Richard Boyd Barrett.
Obviously, I welcome the fact that there has been a postponement of a couple of the episodes of the flogging. But I cannot help but note the stark difference between the tone of concern raised by yourself and by European leaders and international leaders when it comes to a case like this, or, as I mentioned, the 17 journalists killed in Gaza is another example, or the fact that there was over 80 beheadings in Saudi Arabia last year, and that would be regular. I mean, Mr. Badawi was lucky in the sense that his flogging took place at the same time as the Charlie Hebdo atrocity, and for that reason has gained some international focus. But what happens when that focus is gone? And this barbaric action continues, and yet all we get from the European Union and from leaders in this country and elsewhere are expressions of concern or appeals to the governments in question, appeals to the Saudi government. But when the Charlie Hebdo atrocities occur, we have a much more vigorous response. We have declarations of zero tolerance. This will not be put up with. I mean, to put it very simply, Minister, we wouldn't allow the embassy of ISIS in Dublin, would we? But the Saudi Arabian embassy is allowed, Yet they're beheading people week in, week out, jailing journalists, flogging them, cutting people's hands off, cutting people's legs off, and we continue to treat them in a normal diplomatic manner. We continue to trade with them. There's no sanctions. There's not the same tone of outrage that we saw expressed in Paris, where it was unequivocal. We will not put up with this. It was like a war against extremism was declared in the aftermath of the Charlie Hebdo affairs, but when atrocities just as bad or worse take place with countries that we happen to do business with, we are much more muted in our language and in the substance of our response.
Thank you, Deputy.
So that's what I want to know, Minister. Where are the sanctions? Where are the penalties? Where are the government-organised protests over the behaviour of the Saudi government, or for that matter, the outrageous attempt by Israel to justify the killing of 17 journalists in Gaza, which they actually publicly justified and called some of those journalists terrorists? So where's the consistency in our concern for human rights and freedom of expression?
Thank you.
And how is that going to be manifest?
Minister.
Thanks, Laskan Corlam. I wish to reiterate, for the benefit of the Deputy and indeed for the benefit of the House, that the case to which the Deputy refers is clearly a cause for real, serious and deep concern. As I mentioned earlier, Ireland has always been to the fore internationally in raising issues of human rights, and the Government's ongoing commitment to human rights is expressed in the recently published Irish Foreign Policy Review, and I invite the Deputy to have a read of it. Ireland, with specific reference to Saudi Arabia, Ireland made two recommendations in its most recent review under the Human Rights Council review process. These were, firstly, that Saudi Arabia set a clear time frame for the enactment and implementation of a law on associations which respects international human rights standards, which was noted by Saudi Arabia. And secondly, that Saudi Arabia prohibit employees of government from requiring guardians' permission to allow women to conduct official business, particularly in situations such as filing complaints for domestic violence, which was indeed accepted by Saudi Arabia. Let me reiterate finally, Laskan Corlam, that this case is a matter of serious concern. Ireland will continue to express our concern through the official channels. We will continue to closely monitor the situation in conjunction with our EU colleagues. And it's our hope that this issue will be dealt with by the Saudi authorities with particular reference to a pardon in respect of the offence, which is an offence that if the behaviour took place in this jurisdiction would not be an offence by any manner or means. And secondly, if a full pardon is not forthcoming, we trust that the issue will be dealt with by way of severity of sentence, which we believe the sentence as currently handed down is by no means in accordance with human rights standards.
Margaret Darrow.